Dr. Fauci warned about upcoming mutations, and he said they might be even more contagious than the Delta variant, which is already 1,000 times more contagious than the Alpha strain. This is the fourth mutation now we're hearing about. How far into the Greek alphabet are we going to go?
Well, I mean, it all depends, and a lot of it depends on us. The deal is, in the reports by Dr. Fauci and the other healthcare leaders, they've pretty much laid out the science. The way these variants come about is basically when the infection rates are high, and right now we're looking at 100,000 a day almost. I think we had that a couple of days this week. But the bottom line is these infection rates go up, there's more of an opportunity for mutants because basically these are just replications of the virus, but then one might be a little bit different with an advantage. And this advantageous new virus goes out and it infects others and it becomes the dominant strain. So the best way we can stop this is to follow these new reinforced protocols, wearing masks, social distancing, and getting vaccinated so we can cut down these infection rates and we can cut down these opportunities or these breeding grounds for new mutants.
And we heard about herd immunity, right? But now we're just hearing about different mutations. I mean, given the vaccine hesitancy and the people around the world who are not able to get vaccines, will we ever reach herd immunity or is this going to keep just mutating? And how will those mutations look different?
Well, nobody really knows. I mean, this is what mutations are. Mutations are basically new strains of the virus that are a little bit different. But as I said before, the more we can cut down on the infection rate, the more we can get people vaccinated, the more we can follow these protocols. And unfortunately, I did a story earlier today on the local news about all the stress and anxiety associated because, hey, we thought we were free. We were going back out to restaurants, having dinner, but now we have to pull back again and cut down these infection rates and cut down these opportunities for more mutants that might even be stronger that maybe vaccines won't work in the future. So we really have to understand that this is very important.
And are you seeing more vaccine hesitancy? Because some people who were reluctant to get vaccinated in the first place are saying, now look at these breakthrough cases. The vaccine apparently didn't work the way it was supposed to if you're getting infected again. I mean, how do you combat that viewpoint?
Right. Well, what I do is I provide them with the scientific data. And overwhelmingly, the data is showing with these new mutant strains, people can have what are called breakthrough infections. These are individuals that receive both Moderna or the Pfizer vaccines or the Johnson & Johnson in 2 weeks have passed, meaning they have the full protection of that vaccine, but they can still get a coronavirus infection. But what I remind my patients is the good news. The good news is if you've been vaccinated, as I told my 85-year-old patient just yesterday, there's a much better chance that if you do have a coronavirus infection, now you have those antibodies in your system, that ability to fight off the coronavirus. And what's happening is people that do get reinfected that were vaccinated, there's a very small possibility that they'll become very, very severely ill or even lose their life. So this is the information I give with the encouragement to continue these vaccinations and let's fight this coronavirus pandemic.
I want to talk to you about boosters because, of course, there is talk that we'll all be getting boosters and it could even be like a flu shot, something we get every year. Is that something you expect anytime soon, A? And B, is it ethical given the World Health Organization is asking for a moratorium on booster shots until people in poorer countries who haven't even had access to one single shot can get vaccinated?
Right. And I read a lot of reports about this. And basically what the World Health Organization is explaining is until we get a world grasp on coronavirus, we're all in danger. Nobody is safe until everybody is better vaccinated because what happens is in these countries that have the vaccine more readily available, such as the United States, well, everybody, you know, we're getting more people vaccinated. We're getting safer. But the problem is in these countries that have a poorer economic system where they can't afford the vaccines, then there's more infection, there's more breeding ground and more opportunity for more of these virulent strains. And it's inevitable. People are going to visit the United States. They're going to visit other countries in Europe and in Asia. So we have to look at it on a worldwide stage and understand that we have to try to get everybody vaccinated as much as possible. And that will help us overall so that we can avoid or at least cut down the opportunity for more of these virulent strains to emerge.
Dr. Timothy Quinn, thank you for joining us tonight on Prime as always.
Hey, thank you for having me.